Okay, there's the phone.
People come in, if they're doing testing for me, there's a laptop computer in the corner here where people can take a test while I'm seeing somebody else, and I try to set this up to be really very functional. The bathroom, which is an amazing thing to show anybody in an office, is probably big enough to be a treatment room, but it's ADA compliant and accessible for handicapped individuals. So you want to come on into office space?
Much see women and children that I'm treating in this space. And sometimes we have team meetings here as well. The other side of the office that I can show you is more of a playroom area. But I don't think of myself as a person who's married to being in the office. The reason I set up this office to begin with is to be able to do pieces of work that I like to do. One is involving myself in integrated care, and you'll be able to see that at the Cutler Health Center at the University of Maine. Here is the playroom area. I try to put a chalkboard on the wall. It's a paint on chalkboard. And the different toys are here. I've never done something where I tried to make the office space so comfortable for other people, but part of my what I was trying to strive for here was to make it as comfortable for me as it is for people I see. And this area is really for teenagers who don't really want to sit on the couch or need to have more room to move about. The office space is used not only by me, but also by my spouse, who's a psychologist, and another colleague who uses it occasionally on the weekends. I have a secretary who comes in. Because of space parameters, we're limited to this footage. She and I come in, we work together on occasional Friday morning, and then she comes in by herself on the day that I'm working in integrated care settings outside of the office and does the paperwork. What I was wanting to talk a little bit about was how I actually got this office. This space used to be a natural food store. When I saw it, it was bare floor, and my colleague, Dr. Monique Kahn, is next door, and she had talked the landlord into making a space for her to practice over there, and there's an apartment up above. I wasn't very keen on practicing in the community where I live. I have three children. My oldest is nearly 17, and then I have a 14-year-old, and the youngest is 10. And the thought of having people coming in and out from the school systems and so forth, where I actually go to the grocery store and so forth, I wasn't sure I really was ready for that kind of dual role relationship. And but I was kind of on the fence about it, so I met with the landlord to kind of look at the space. And in talking with him, I explained my hesitation. And he said, you know, I think it would be so nice to have you here. It would be like having a patriarch. It would be comforting. And so when you use the word patriarch to describe me, then I started laughing, and I thought to myself, I'm going to take this office space. So I think of myself as maybe being a little comforting to people that live here in town, that they know that they come see me, but they also live here and work here and so forth. What I set this up as a practice where I didn't necessarily have to be in the office, that I could do pieces of things that I enjoy doing. So I tried to put together work with OB setting, work with pediatrics, and so on Mondays I go work in an integrated care program called the WOW program to do consulting work there. I want to speak a little bit about the WOW program. You'll be able to see photographs of Dr. Valerie O'Hara, who is a pediatrician and director of our program. Also, Star Johnston, who is our, as we call her, nurse extraordinaire. I'm also showing a picture of me with one of our students, Morgan McGillicuddy. The students that work in the WOW program are doctoral students at the University of Maine, Orno. There were three doctoral students working under my supervision this spring, and it appears that we may actually have four in the fall. And so I do serve as adjunct professor in the psychology department, which is another lovely way to diversify one's life as a rural psychologist. My work with integrated care is not limited to the WOW program. However, I am involved in both
initiatives at the national level through the American Psychological Association, also through the Maine Primary Care Association. I serve on the Maine Migrant Health Program Board as the chair, which gives me a seat on the Maine Primary Care Association Board. I also work with the Maine Psychological Association with regard to initiatives to recruit and retain psychologists in integrated care roles. So there is a committee on integrated care within the state, and I chair, co-chair that with Dr. Rob Ferguson. So the photos should give you a good sense of what the WOW program is like. We have a great deal of fun, and I am thrilled with that particular job. Prior to my involvement with the WOW program, I was involved in a joint project between Eastern Maine Medical Center and the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia involving post-traumatic medical stress. That was a really fun project to be involved with, working with the nurses to help collect data on post-traumatic medical stress on the inpatient pediatric floor. At the Eastern Maine Medical Center, I participate in pediatric service meetings and in pediatric grand rounds. I've helped facilitate talks on obesity and on eating disorders for pediatric grand rounds. I'm currently transferring my privileges at Eastern Maine Medical Center from psychiatry to pediatrics, where I'll be located in developmental pediatrics.
At the medical center, I go down there and work in a space with social workers up on Grand 8, and I'm very comfortable working there, and hopefully that will develop into some hospital consultation work on Grand 8. So I tried on the front end, before I opened this office, to think about what I wanted to do. The reason I see women and children, I felt like I really need to focus on what I feel like I do well at. And when I thought about that, I thought caring for women and children. I feel like if there's anything that I do well, it's caring for other people. So that I made that sort of my tagline on all of my materials that I sent out. And I feel like that it's the end product has been I've been very happy with my life because I'm doing things that I really love to do, and I don't feel particularly like I have to do anything that I don't want to do. The other thing that I did with the practice that you can do in a rural area that you might not be able to do in an urban area is I went ahead and decided to make the decision to set a cash fee, and I reduced my fee because I was asking people to pay up front, and provided them with a super bill to submit to insurance if they wish. And so far that really has not been a major problem. If I have somebody who has to see somebody, has to have somebody that bills insurance directly, I've been able to refer to colleagues, and the referrals are it's a plenty. I'm full, and that has not been a barrier for me here. So it's really worked out quite well. This is my picture with Senator Olympia Snow from last year from the legislative dinner, that's just an example of some of the things you can do as a rural psychologist. You wouldn't think about making trips to Washington, being involved with federal advocacy, being involved with legislators like Senator Snow, but that has been a delightful part of my life in Maine. I've been able to serve as the federal advocacy coordinator for the Maine Psychological Association. So every year I get to go to the annual state leadership conference and help raise money to bring Snow to this dinner. And it's just been tremendously exciting and enriching experience. Working in a rural area, don't think about isolation as being as big of a problem as maybe it was at one time, because there are all kinds of ways that you can make sure that you get the stimulation you need as a professional.